Did you know that your camera can make the most appalling cock-up of your exposures? It doesn't mean to, it's certainly not being malicious. It's because the manufacturers have programmed the light meter to believe that the world is mid-grey. Mid-grey is halfway between white and black. It's exactly in the middle. Now, why would they do such a foolish thing as to tell your camera that that's what the world looks like? It's because the camera can't think, but it does need a starting point. It needs somewhere to begin with an exposure. And if you take average tones in average light, kind of like what you're seeing behind me here, it usually does equate to pretty much mid-grey. But if you start photographing something that's predominantly bright or predominantly dark, the camera can get it very wrong. Here's a little exercise which I'd urge you to try out at home to help you get your head around it. What I've got is a sheet of, well, really it's very dark red velvet, but it's close enough to black not to matter, and a piece of white photographic printing paper. I've set the camera to shoot in black and white because I don't want you getting confused about colours. This is about tones. Now, if I fill the viewfinder with the white, and I'm using an auto setting, in this case aperture priority, so the camera is working out the exposure for me, and I take a picture, there we go, and then I take another one of the black, no white in the black shot, no black in the white shot, and there we go. If you're shooting this at home, there's a good chance you may have to manually focus because solid blocks of colour often confuse the focus. Now, if we look at those two shots, let's just flick back and forth between them here. That's the white, and you can see the histogram is just here. It's made it grey. That's the black, or the dark red, and again, the histogram is in a very similar place. Look, nothing's really moved. The camera has made white into grey and black into grey. Now then, if I fill the frame with exactly half white and half black, right down the middle, try not to get my shadow in it. If we look at that, look, it's got it absolutely bang on. The white's white and the black's black, and the histogram is at either end. So why did it manage to do that? It's because 50% white and 50% black equal grey. So the camera managed to get it spot on. Let me show you another little thing. I need a tripod for this so you know I'm not cheating. I've got the camera locked off with the viewfinder filled completely with the white. Now you can see on the top here that it's giving me a shutter speed of a 6,000th of a second. Now, if I suddenly whip that piece of white out the way and watch the shutter speed plummet, it's got slower because it thinks it needs more light. The light hasn't changed, the camera didn't change. All that happened was the tonality of what the camera was looking at changed. So that's all there is to it, really. You just need to be aware of the fact that your camera can get confused in extreme circumstances.